Hi, I'm Bob Boerner. I'm one of the product support engineers at Plugable Technologies. And what I'd like to do today is demonstrate some of the different display mirroring options available when using a Mac. So what is that and why would that be useful? Well, let's take a look at what I have on my desk here. I have an Apple Mac Mini 2020 model with an M1 processor connected to a Plugable UD-6950Z dual 4K display docking station. I've got two LG 4K displays connected to the dock, and I actually have a portable ViewSonic display connected directly to one of the Thunderbolt ports on the back of the Mac. And the reason this works, that I can have these three external displays, is because of the display link technology in this dock. But what I want to show is, first of all, that each of these displays is unique. They are an extension of the desktop. And I can do that. I've got this application window open. It's a text edit window. And I can move that between all the displays to show that they are, in fact, unique and extensions. But what if I don't want or need that? What if I want to make it so that one or more of these displays is a mirror image of one another? Well, let me show you how you can do that. Let me change my view so you can see my desktop and still see what's happening on all the displays. The way you can change this is by coming down to System Preferences, clicking on that, and then clicking on the Displays option. And macOS will show a visual representation of all three displays connected to the Mac. If I hover the pointer over each display, I'll see a little pop-up or balloon note that tells me what the display name is. It says that this display here on the left is LG Ultra HD number one. The display on the right up here is LG Ultra HD display number two. And the portable ViewSonic display, which is a VG1655 model, is the third display down here. And these individual boxes are representations of the fact that each is an extension of the overall desktop and they are unique. But what if I don't want that? What if I want all of them to show the same thing, to be mirrors of one another? Well, there's a couple ways to do it, but the way I like to do it is I can click on this display over here on the right and say mirror for LG Ultra HD number one. Now remember, this display is LG Ultra HD number one. When I do that, you'll see that now I'm seeing the identical image on both displays. And when I move one window, you can see it move on the other because it's a mirror. And what macOS is doing is showing those two displays stacked on top of one another to indicate that they are in fact mirrors. All right, what if I want to take that a step further? If I want to take the ViewSonic portable display and mirror that, I can simply right-click on it and say mirror for LG Ultra HD number one. And now all three displays are showing the same thing. And now they're all stacked together to indicate they're all mirrors. If I move an application window on one, it moves on all three. All right. That could be useful if, say, you had multiple displays connected to a system facing, for example, different directions at a presentation and you wanted everybody to see the same thing. Okay, what if I want to undo this? I can just simply right-click on the stack and select Stop Mirroring. And in just a moment, everything should go back to the way it was originally and that they all are extensions and unique. So if I move my application window again, you can see the application window move back and forth. All right, well, what else could you do with this? You can selectively mirror displays. They don't always have to be the primary display in the system. For example, let's say I'm gonna move my application window over here to LG display number two. And I want this display and this display to be mirrors of one another. Let's say, for example, I was in a customer service situation. I had two displays on my desk, but I had one display facing the customer, and I wanted them to see exactly what was on my one display, but not the other. All right, the way you can do that is come over here, and now instead of mirroring for LG display number one, which is over here, I'm going to mirror for LG Ultra HD display number two. So when I do that, now these two are mirrored and it shows them stacked to represent that. And if I move the application window, you can see that these two are the mirror now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this back and stop the mirroring just to put everything back the way it was for a moment. While that's not the most exciting thing in and of itself, depending on what your specific task is or what you need to do, the fact that macOS allows you to selectively mirror things in whichever way that you want, something that Windows can't do, can be actually very useful depending on what you need to accomplish. So if you found that interesting or useful, please be sure to like this video and please be sure to subscribe to our channel.